Yes, we are tired. I've 23 years living under the same government and it has always been the same.
It's terrible, a fraud. We won with 70% and maybe even more.
La crisis.
Crisis serve to grow.
Sirven.
They want to create a political crisis.
Ellos quieren crear una crisis política.
Welcome to the show. The streets of Venezuela have been ringing to the defiant bangs of pots and pans as thousands protest the results of an election they claim was rigged. Security forces responded with tear gas and rubber bullets. Several people were killed and dozens wounded across the country. The rally started after Venezuela's authoritarian leader Nicolas Maduro was handed a third term in office. The opposition claims it won by a landslide. Amid a wave of demonstrations, Maduro accuses right-wing extremists of stirring up a political crisis. That as more and more people demand change and say they no longer fear the regime's repression.
Venezuela's election results ignited fury on the streets of Caracas. Thousands of protesters descended on the capital to denounce President Nicolas Maduro's victory.
I came to the street because we want freedom. We are tired of this government. We want a change. We want to be free in Venezuela. We want our families to return here. We don't want them to leave anymore. We want to be free with our families.
Earlier, security forces fired tear gas and rubber bullets at protesters who say the election was rigged. Electoral authorities say Maduro won 51% of the vote, but have yet to show a full breakdown of the results. Venezuela's opposition claims it received over 70%.
We have in our hands the tally sheets that prove our categorical and mathematically irreversible triumph.
The president accuses his opponents of trying to destabilize Venezuela.
The extreme right are behind this plan. They were screaming fraud 15 days before the elections. They didn't sign the agreement to recognize the election result.
Maduro's 11-year rule has seen Venezuela descend into economic chaos and a mass exodus. About a quarter of the population has left the country. While his international allies, Iran, Russia, and China, have congratulated him on the election win, others, including the US, have condemned the results. Several Latin American countries, as well as international bodies, including the UN, have called on Venezuelan authorities to release voting records from individual polling stations.
We can cross over to Caracas now and speak to DW correspondent Oscar Schlenker. Oscar, good to see you. More protests today in Venezuela. You've been out in Caracas. What did people tell you?
Well, people are angry. People are angry and they want the world to know that when they went out to vote, most of the people around them, anybody that they knew, was intending to vote for the opposition. And a lot of people that were witnesses in the voting centers say that they have the tallies that the machines print out that show that Edmundo González Urrutia was the rightful winner of this election. So a lot of people are just protesting because many of them think this is their last chance to have change in a country in a democratic way. And they want to defend that right that they have to want change in this country in a peaceful manner.
The opposition isn't giving in either. They've been presenting evidence to back up their version of the election outcome. How is the regime responding?
Well, Nicolas Maduro and a lot of the institutions that are loyal to his administration have responded with threats. They have already threatened to imprison Maria Corina Machado and Edmundo González Urrutia. They want to make them responsible for the deaths and the injured in yesterday's protests. And they've already said that they are investigating different kinds of cases to incriminate Maria Corina Machado, specifically with a massive hack against the Electoral Council system, in which they say was conducted from North Macedonia, and is implicating also a couple of opposition leaders that are not in Venezuela, Lester Toledo and Leopoldo López.
In the past, Maduro has relied heavily on his security apparatus to quash dissent. It looks like this is the strategy now again. But I want to know from you, where does the military support for him stand today?
Well, today, military support stands with Maduro. The defense minister, Padrino López, has already emitted several statements that clearly indicate that he supports what the Electoral Council has pronounced and in defense to the revolution and to Nicolás Maduro.
We have, once again, two parties claiming victory. A couple of years ago, and our viewers might remember, a man called Juan Guaidó proclaimed himself Venezuela's president in a similar scenario. He was recognized by dozens of countries as Venezuela's legitimate leader, until he eventually lost support in the country. What lessons did Venezuela's opposition learn from that era?
Well, for one thing, he wasn't elected as president. He was the president of the National Assembly of the Congress. And now we are seeing that there are ballots that prove there was a winner in this election. And the opposition played the regime's game all throughout this campaign, where it wasn't free and fair. We had seen a lot of obstacles given to the opposition, including persecution. They closed down businesses where they would stay or have any kind of a relation with during the campaign trail. And they kept at it peacefully, playing the game that the government was putting upon them. And now they have the tallies to show that people did in fact vote for them, and the Electoral Council is not showing anything. And that's one of the things that they are claiming as their victory. However, one of the biggest problems that the opposition has had in the past is being fractioned. We saw in these last few days that even the opposition candidates that were independent and are in opposition of the official opposition or of the largest opposition, they've come out and said that they do not believe either in these results. So we are seeing more unity in the opposition right now, and that could be a key to claiming their victory.
Yeah, and to keeping up the pressure. What role do you think countries in the region could play in resolving this dispute? Because there has been an immediate response.
Yes, I think especially the countries in the region, the neighboring countries, they have more of a claim to what could happen. Because if the Maduro regime does in fact stay in power, we are going to see a massive amount of people migrating again. And the countries that are more affected are Colombia and Brazil. Now, we've seen that in the last few hours, Venezuela has expelled over at least seven countries from diplomatic embassies here in Venezuela. And that results in more isolation for Nicolas Maduro's administration. But they double down with those that do support them, like Russia, China, Cuba, Nicaragua, Bolivia.
We have about half a minute, but I do want to know, is there a scenario in which you do see Maduro making concessions?
I think in either, however this plays out, then Nicolás Maduro's administration has to negotiate. They have to negotiate either with the international community or with the opposition. But I think negotiations are to come after all this plays out.
That was DW's Oskar Szlenka from Caracas. Thank you. Always great speaking to you.